In this video, what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to set up Reddit ads and a couple things that will help you if you're running Reddit ads. Now, this is a demo account. I just run some tests in this account. This isn't the main account that I use for running Reddit ads, obviously because intellectual privacy and all of that stuff. But I do want to show you how to do this. So this is really cool. You can go to ads.reddit.com, sign up for your account. Okay. And when you're there, one of the things that I encourage you to do in the beginning is go to the ad inspiration. And this shows you ads that are actually running on Reddit, top Reddit ads. And you can search for these in different verticals. This will show basically all the industries, and you can get a sense of how Reddit ads are a little bit different than other types of ads. And this is a good example of one. This is one where it's using a meme. And memes sometimes can be really good ideas for Reddit ads. I talk about this in my Reddit ads course, and I'll link that in the description below. But this is just a quick intro so that you can understand how to run your own ads. So let's say you have a product that's about meditation. You can do a search here, and it will show you how many ads are about this or that are related to this, which is pretty cool. So this is a really interesting way to do some competitive research. And you can also search for different formats, just video formats, and it will just show you that. Or you can look at different industries if you want. Okay. So these are all video ads that you can see here that have been running. And let's say you wanted to search in a particular industry, you could do that as well. So let's see what's going on in the financial services industry. Okay. So as you can see here, here's another one that's like a meme ad. So these are just some ideas to get you started. And you can see some of them are in different languages. So that's pretty cool. But what I want to do is I want to show you how to actually create a campaign from scratch, because this is the most important thing. And I'll tell you why and what steps that you'll need for this. So first, you're going to give the campaign a name. So I'm just going to call it test campaign. And if it's a special ad category related to that, then you want to check that. Next up, you're going to want to choose your objective. And this is similar for other ad platforms. But what I like about this is when you select each one, it's going to say exactly where your optimization is for. So you're paying cost per M, CPM, cost per 1,000 impressions, and optimized towards impressions. Where if you went for traffic, it will be clicks. And this will be optimized for conversions, optimized for video views, app installs, that sort of thing. So I'm going to go for traffic because that's probably the easiest place to start. And you can put a cap on your spending, right? So let's just put $200 as a cap. So that's an overall cap on the campaign, okay? And so now we've got two saved audiences. So I'm not going to use saved audiences, but this is where the real magic is with Reddit. And you could certainly do keywords. So you can add different keywords here if you already know specific keywords, but you can also build a audience community. And this I think is really important. These are some ones that I've added on other campaigns. And this is where you're going to want to do some research. So it does, if you hover over it, give you the estimated users and basically what it's about. But let's just say I wanted to build something on AI. So I can see Character AI, which is a popular app that allows you to chat with different people, like fictitious people. Singularity is on machine learning. And you can see how many users are on this. And this, you really want to dig into what you want to advertise on. They also allow cryptocurrency ads. So you can see you can advertise very specific to very specific users. And this is where it gets interesting, is because you want to think about how specific you're going to be this audience, you're going to get with this audience, and the ad that you're going to run, right? So let's just put, I'm just going to do side hustle. Let's put that in. And then it will give me some other suggested Reddits, okay, that are related to that. So I could do passive income, make money, this sort of thing. Now, if I'm running ads for clients, I'm going to do a lot more research than I'm doing here, but just so you understand. They also have interest groups. So this is based on what people have interacted with recently. So that's another way to target. So you don't even need to use keywords. If you do have specific keywords, then it will be a both and situation where you're going to be targeting people that are in these communities that like these specific keywords. Now, when it comes to dynamic audience, expand your audience, turn this off because they're going to start giving you a ton of traffic. This is if you've got a massive budget and you want to spread it and you want them to figure out the targeting. So in most cases, that's not going to be new. So you can add some custom audience here. So I've got a retargeting group here where you can exclude that. And then you can also include specific demographics. So by region of state, by area in that state, or by countries. And so most of the cases, you're going to want to add some targeting here, just to, particularly if you're new at advertising, make sure your ads are meeting the right audience. So we can just put in Canada and click that. And we can put in, let's say, United Kingdom. Okay. And this is going to encourage you to expand your audience. And as you can see, each of these is a limiting factor. So when I add new demographics or new Reddit threads, it's got to be people that are in those areas, right? So they have to be in Canada, the United States, or United Kingdom, and also interested in these threads or these Reddits. Okay. So now what you're going to do is you're going to choose a type here. Or sorry, you can actually choose the genders. And so this can be men, women, all, whatever it is that your ads are, your demographic is more targeting, then do that. And you can also target some of these specific devices. So you can target just users on iOS, just on Android, or just on desktop. Keep in mind that if you turn off the Android and iOS, then you might have like a higher price, right? Because users on the desktop are going to be more preferred for advertisers. Okay. So you can exclude certain keywords if you want, and then you can have it in the feed or the placement. So the feed is where people are scrolling Reddit and they're going to see ads there. And you can also have it in the conversation. So this is an interesting thing about Reddit ads, is you can actually just get it right in where people are having conversations. And so right now it's on both, but conversations is interesting here because then you can focus just on people that are engaging on Reddit. And one of the most important things about Reddit, or the most interesting things about Reddit, is it's a place where people will communicate and debate. And the comments are a huge source of interest. So the budget, I think there's a minimum budget of $5 a day or $10 a day. And so this is a daily budget. You can set a start time. So I'm just going to set a start time in the future. And you can also set an end date. Okay. And so it'll give you here, you'll spend about $6 per day on this ad group, because the way that they do it is their budget, they actually allow it to possibly run a little bit over. So that's something to keep in mind. So up to $6 per day. Now, if your targeting is tight and you might not even reach the $6 a day, right? So keep that in mind as well. And that's why it's really important to do targeting. We do a whole other video just on targeting. So with this one now here, because it's giving me the lowest cost or a cost cap, okay? So this is recommended for volume, or keep the average cost below the cap while getting as many clicks as possible. So this is where it comes in, and then it can give you, based on what I've selected here, it's going to give me an estimate of how much that's going to spend. And it's going to give me a recommended limit. So I can actually edit this. Obviously, if you edit it too low, let's just put in 44, that's below the limit. I still might get some traffic, but I'm not going to necessarily get as much traffic as I want. But then again, and they're not going to necessarily serve you the best clients, right? Because it's all based on an auction. And if someone's willing to pay for better clients, then you got to keep that in mind as well. So advertising is always a little bit about making some concessions, I guess you could say. All right. So let's gonna give this ad a name, and we're going to give this ad a name, and we're going to call new AI tool. Okay. And you can publish it under your profile. This is set up under the settings. And so now it's going to allow me to do an image, okay, a video, a carousel, or a free form. So when you're starting out, probably the image is going to be the easiest to do. And so I'm just going to upload an image here. And in this case, this is just an example. So I'm going to be doing a let's use an example here. And so this is for a video that I did for the Sensate Pebble. I'll put a link in the description. It's a really interesting tool. But you put in a headline here, and this can be quite a longer headline. You do want to think about this. Sometimes shorter headlines work well. Again, there's going to be some testing. So here's the image. Here's the thumbnail, and you'll see that this is cropped. So this, you can replace this with a suitable image. So if you're in Canva and you have something like this, what you want to do is you want to resize your design to this other one, because as I can see here in the corner, it's cutting off from about here. It's cutting off about half this speech bubble, and that wouldn't be good for an ad. Okay. So then I'm going to put a link to it. Okay. And you can add a source parameter, which I would really recommend to use, because then it's going to have that source. When you're looking at your analytics, or you have your marketing team look at your analytics, that would be ideal. And actually, let's just, so this is a demo ad, let's just send it straight to a website. And this isn't really making sense, because that was a link redirect. And so now I don't have that error there. This is just an example, so I just want to show you how that works. Now, the call to action here, this is something else you can choose. There's quite a few options here. I'm going to put learn more, although pre-order now is a little bit interesting, because depending on what Reddits you're targeting, a lot of Redditors want to be early on something. And so now we've got that all set up. And one more thing that I should mention is this is a really important aspect of your ads. You can allow comments or not allow comments. And I'd encourage you to look at some of the different ads there and start checking out the ads on your own Reddit feed before you do that. What you'll find with Redditors is sometimes they'll give very negative comments just because they can be very skeptical as a group of people. So that's definitely something to keep in mind when you're looking at allowing comments. So it's off by default. Let's leave it like that. And click review. Okay. This is going to review. It's going to give you the name, no special category, and then all the targeting details here, the max bid, all that stuff. And then it's going to let me publish that ad. Okay. So once the ad is published, that's really all that you need to do. Okay. So that's going to be published. And then you'll see here, it'll say not delivering. Okay. And one of the, let's just say we're very satisfied with that. Okay. Let's skip that. All right. So here you can toggle the ad on and off. Okay. And as you can see, it's not delivering. And the reason for that is because of, it needs to be approved, right? So you can rename the ad here. P-E-B-L-E. Okay. And here's where you can go into some of the different things. So you can view the insights and things like that. But if you click here in this ad, you'll move to the next column here, which is the ad group. Okay. And on the ad group, this is where, again, you'll see the name there. But if I want to change any of the details about it, this is where I can edit the ad group. I can duplicate it. I can view the history of it. I can view the insights once the ad has started to run. So here you see the history, and this is interesting because this will just track all the different changes that you've done. And as you can see, I just set up the ad and it's tracked all these different changes and put a timestamp. So you can see exactly what's been done to the ad. If I wanted to duplicate the ad group, I could do that. But if I wanted to edit it, I would also be able to click that button and then just change anything about the ad group. So this would be changing the ad group settings, right? Which is really about the targeting, right? If I wanted to add a different Reddit group, or let's say I wanted to find something more in the side hustle, then, you know, Dave Ramsey, that'd be perfect for this ad, right? So I can click on that and add that. Again, as I said, try to do your research before you, the Reddits that you're going to run the ad on, before you start coming in and doing the ad. It's easy to do it in here. I always really encourage you to check out, take that extra time and really look at what kind of posts are going on in that Reddit, in that subreddit, before running an ad on it. Okay, make sure there's an alignment there. You can also create a new ad, right? So if you wanted another ad in that ad group, this is a great way you can have maybe test a different creative. You could do that as well. And if I click in here or I click here on the ad, then I will go right to the ad level and this will come here and it can see it's pending approval. I'm just going to turn it off right here because obviously I don't want this ad to run. And if I wanted to edit it, I could create a test URL and all that info here, and we'll create the URL, and then it will basically show you here what it will look like in the feed placement and what it will look like in the conversations area. So let's test this, and I'm actually just in Brave, so that's going to block the ads with the settings that I have set up. So I'm just going to open this in a new window here. All right. So here is a test post with a lot of comments on it, and we should see the ad somewhere here. I see this other ad here, so that's how it would look here in the comments. Here is another ad. So you can see a sense of how your ad would look. And, you know, if we go back here to this one, then let's paste that in there. And here is the ad here, right? So this is actually like showing me my actual ad, how it would look. And you can see, you know, promoted right there. That's how it would look in that format. And then right here, this is how it would look in this format. And it's actually pretty interesting, actually. I think this ad could do okay on Reddit if I had done a little bit more on it, because it's an interesting visual. So it's important to have a visual that's going to jump out, but at the same time, you want to make sure that this is fitting with that particular Reddit audience. Okay. So that's how your ads will look. And then it will start generating your data here once you've got that. So overall, it's a really easy experience to start running Reddit ads. It's really powerful because you can target specific subreddits. And that's where the magic really is with Reddit ads, when you can target those specific subreddits and get your message in front of the right people. And because of that, I find that Reddit ads are one of the easiest platforms to get some good traffic on. So if you do need help, I've got a couple of resources. I'll put those links in the description. I've got a course that teaches you more in depth of how to create Reddit ads and goes into a lot of the things that you'll need to understand in order to really perform at the best on the Reddit platform and the Reddit ads platform. And the second thing is, if you need help running ads yourself, then you can reach out and hire me to run ads on Reddit for you or some of the other platforms. And that would be linked in the description as well. But for some people, this may be all they need to get started with Reddit ads. And again, if you're just starting out, set a tight budget, really do that targeting and just try it out and see how that helps to grow your brand or your business. If you have any questions, hit me up in the comments. And that's it for this video. We'll see you in the next one. If you have not already, make sure that you like this video, make sure you subscribe it. And if you want good karma for the rest of the day, share it, even on Reddit. Just give it a share, and we'll see you in the next video.